Simply Mechanisms, one in a series of videos where I look at organic chemistry mechanisms. And here I look at the reaction of 1-bromo-2-methylpropane, a tertiary haloalkane, with aqueous potassium hydroxide. The mechanism is known as SN1, nucleophilic substitution first order. And here's my tertiary haloalkane, 1-bromo-2-methylpropane. The CBr bond is polar. The pair of electrons of the CBr bond spend more time around the bromine as it's more electronegative. So we assign a delta positive to the carbon to show that it's slightly electron deficient, and a delta minus to bromine to show that it's slightly electron rich. Now this, as is typical of mechanisms, a two-step mechanism, with the first step being the slow step, also known as the rate determining step. In this particular mechanism, only the haloalkane molecule is involved in the slow step. And this curly arrow, as is always the case, tracks the movement of two electrons, and it's showing heterolytic fission of the CBr bond. The two electrons go off with the bromine. So the bromine will leave with an extra electron, it will leave as a bromide ion. And here's the intermediate that's forming. When that CBr bond breaks in that way, heterolytically, the carbon loses the electron it contributed to the bond, so it's effectively down an electron, and I therefore need to show a positive charge on that carbon, like so, and that's referred to as a carbocation. And as the carbon has three other alkyl groups attached to it, which by the way are electron donating, it means that it's a tertiary carbocation. The bromine then took both electrons of that bond, so it has an extra electron and is in fact a bromide ion, Br minus. Now it's the tradition in these mechanisms that when a bond disappears, so to speak, then we show where those electrons have gone using two dots. So I need to put in a moment two dots on the bromide ion. And first of all, emphasizing here where the one comes from in the title SN1. It means that the reaction is first order. What does that mean? Well, it simply means that there is one particle involved in the slow step, in this case the haloalkane molecule. In the SN2 mechanism, and you may have looked at that video already, where a primary haloalkane reacts with aqueous hydroxide ions, there are two particles involved. So this has only one particle, and when we make reference to what's known as the molecularity of the reaction, we count the number of particles in the slow step. And this is known as a unimolecular reaction, uni meaning one. Now, if you're familiar with quantitative kinetics, you'll be familiar with how we construct the so-called rate equation. Here equals K times the concentration of the tertiary haloalkane molecule to the power of one, because there's one particle of that involved in the slow step, and doubling its concentration will double the rate of the reaction. You see that the concentration of hydroxide ions is to the power of zero because it's not involved in the slow step, and anything to the power of zero is one. So in fact we can remove that part from the expression, and the rate equation then is simply equals K, the rate constant, lowercase k, times the concentration of the tertiary haloalkane molecule to the power of one. That's the significance of the one in the SN1 title, substitution, nucleophilic, first order. Again, this is the case with the tertiary haloalkane. So let's tidy up the intermediates there. You see that I've put the two dots on the bromide ion. Those two dots represent the two electrons of what had been the CBr bond of the tertiary haloalkane. So at this stage I've got a tertiary carbocation and bromide ions. Then we're ready for the fast step, and this is where the other reagent will get involved, the aqueous hydroxide ions. And as the hydroxide ions have a negative charge, we can see why this reaction is going to be fast, as it'll be a reaction between hydroxide ions and the positive carbocation. Now, as this is the fast step, it has no control over the rate of the reaction. So long as hydroxide ions are present, doesn't matter whether there's a little or a lot, it won't influence the speed of the reaction. So here are my hydroxide ions coming in now for the fast step. And this is the nucleophilic part of the reaction. Normally, the title comes from what's happening in the slow step, and usually here, the nucleophile is coming in the fast step. This is nucleophilic attack. The nucleophile OH- is attacking the carbocation. Now that second curly arrow again tracks the movement of two electrons. It's showing that the two electrons of the OH- nucleophile are about to form a bond with the carbon there bearing the positive charge. And we will then get a tertiary alcohol produced as a result. And there you see the structure of the product. We've replaced the Br- nucleophile with the OH- nucleophile. So we need to show the bromide ions as well there. And if we'd used potassium hydroxide, aqueous potassium hydroxide, then the other product would be potassium bromide. And the name of the tertiary alcohol, 2-methylpropan-2-ol. So where we use a tertiary haloalkane with aqueous potassium hydroxide, we have an SN1 mechanism. If you've looked at the earlier video at SN2, a primary haloalkane with aqueous hydroxide ions undergoes an SN2 mechanism. And then finally, for the sake of completeness, let me use a reaction profile diagram to show you why primary haloalkanes prefer to undergo SN2 than SN1. Here's the profile diagram for what we've just looked at, the SN1 route for a tertiary haloalkane forming an alcohol. And that little dip in the middle of the profile diagram represents the intermediate that forms. You see it at the top there, the tertiary carbocation. What's making that unstable is the positive charge on the carbon that's missing an electron. Those alkyl groups attached to that carbon, and there are three of them, they are electron donating. And by donating electrons towards that carbon, they make it somewhat less unstable. And if it's less unstable, that means it's got a lower enthalpy. Now in the case of a primary haloalkane, it would form the equivalent primary carbocation, which would only have one alkyl group attached to the carbon bearing the positive charge. It would be even more unstable than the tertiary carbocation intermediate. And you can see with the red line here that it would have to take a route, which means going through a higher enthalpy or forming an intermediate, a primary carbocation intermediate with a much higher enthalpy, much more unstable. And as a result, the activation energy for that first slow step is simply too high to overcome. So in the case of primary haloalkanes, they prefer to undergo the SN2 mechanism, where both the haloalkane and the hydroxide ions are involved in the slow rate determining step. So that's been my look at the SN1 mechanism for tertiary haloalkanes reacting with aqueous hydroxide ions. Do please consider looking at others in this series entitled Simply Mechanisms. Thanks for listening.